So indexes, what are indexes? Indexes are created on the key columns in a database table so that the querying becomes faster. So it's same as the index that we have in a book, in a PDF book, in an ebook. So you just click on that number in any document you have an index, you click on that and you directly go to that page. So it's for faster searching. That is the whole purpose of having an index on a table. It's for faster searching. Now, the different kinds of indexes, there is a primary index, there is a foreign key index, there is an alternate key index, and this is there is an inversion entry index. Now, these are the terms in the logical data model. Now, let's look at what are these indexes. The primary index is the index for the primary key column. So, whenever you define an entity and you define a primary key for that entity, an index is auto-created by Erwin. And that becomes your primary key index for that table. You can have only one primary index for a table, though a primary key index can have multiple columns in it. So a primary key index, it could be a combination. Your primary key could be a combination of two columns. So in that case, it becomes a primary, there becomes a primary key index on that table that is a combination of columns. Primary index is unique, so same characteristics as the ones for the primary keys in your table. It has to be unique, no nulls, no repeating values. Now, foreign key index, again, it's automatically created. So whenever you establish a relationship between two tables and your foreign key is generated for one of your tables, then a foreign key index would be automatically created for your entity. Again, it could be a combination of columns. Alternate key index, it's alternate key index in the logical model. In the physical model, it is called as the unique index. So it's an alternative unique index to the primary key index. So it's any other column on which can be used. Any other column in an entity apart from the primary key of the entity that can be used to uniquely identify the records of the table. So for example, we have a customer table, then we can have customer account number as the primary key of the table. So we will have a primary key index on the customer account number column. So the customer account number uniquely identifies the records in the customer table, and we have a primary key index on that column. There might also be a customer phone number that might also be a unique identifier for that table. So we might have a table which has the customers in it, and the customer phone numbers are unique for each customer. So that might be a unique identifier again for the table, but that's not a primary key. We have not defined it as a primary key. But we can define an index on this column. So that becomes an alternate key index. Then the fourth kind of index is the inversion entry index. The inversion entry index is basically called as a non-unique index in the physical data model. So inversion entry index is a term that is used in the logical data model. In the physical data model, it is called the inversion entry index. So this index is on any non-unique column of the table. And because it's on the non-unique column of the table, duplicate values are allowed for this column. Now, these are the four kinds of indexes. Why do we need them? Primary index, obviously, primary key of the table. We need a primary index efficiently. Foreign key index, again, foreign key index is needed because you want to join between the tables. A foreign key is there when there's a relationship between two entities or tables, and when we want to fetch the data for the final query output or for the reports, we would obviously have a need to join between, and that's why we should have an index on the foreign index as well. Why do we need an alternate key index? when you already have a primary key index, why would we need an alternate key index? So sometimes there is a column that is repeatedly being queried upon. Sometimes it's a column which is repeatedly being joined upon in your queries further down in your data model, or if it's a data warehouse, when you're generating a report, there might be some business identifiers, unique columns, which we are constantly joining them upon. That's why we need to have an index on those columns as well. Because the primary key is often not the business identifier in a table. It's always a generated column. So it is non-business relevant values. Those are self-generated values. So it's a good approach to have an identifier on the business identifiers as well. So not the primary key of the table, but they identify the records uniquely in a table. And they are needed again because we need to perform joins on that table when we are joining data between different tables and loading it into further target tables or querying it for the reports. And why do we need an inversion entry index? It's non-unique. Okay. And duplicate values are also allowed, so that would make the system slower. It might make the system slower, but again, for the same purposes, sometimes we have reporting requirements that need us to have an index on those columns. Sometimes the requirements further down in our data model when we are loading some other target systems that we need to perform a join on those columns. So that is a need. Then that becomes a need for having an inversion. The column that might have repeating values. That's a non-unique index. That is the need for all these indexes. Now, indexes are also very important for a data model, because without indexes, nothing would work. If you do not create an index, your query would be so slow, it would time out. So that your data model would never work, you would never be able to load the data, you would never be able to read the data in the data model. So you must have indexes. That's why Erwin creates automatically the primary indexes on the table and the foreign key indexes. So you have indexes, but when you have a large database, you will see, especially in data warehousing and all the large databases, if you do not have indexes, your queries would all time out. You will have no output. Your system would hang. So you need to have indexes. You need to be very wise with designing your indexes as well, because over-indexing your database also has penalties. It makes it, again, inefficient. You have too many indexes because you need to maintain those indexes. You need database spaces for those indexes. And loading becomes difficult when you have indexes on the table. So you have to be very careful. You should have the necessary indexes. You should have the optimum indexes on the table. That optimum limit has to be there on the indexes. You should not be under-indexed, should not be over-indexed on your database. So you need to have a good understanding of this concept as well, of the indexes and how to efficiently design indexes for your database tables in your data model. So these are important concepts. Now, this is conceptual. Now, let's go to the Erwin Data Modeler tool and see what are the options for creating the indexes, how are they created, where can we see them and do manipulations with them. So, again, I go to the tool, I open a new model, I choose the logical, physical, whatever database I'm fine with that. Okay. It opens up my model in the logical view. I add an entity. Let's take the same example, student. Then I add student ID. I add student first name. I add, okay. Sorry. So it came out of it. I need to change it again. Oh, okay. Right click. Doesn't allow me to rename. Okay. So student. And I have the student first name. Let me add another entity over here. call it course. Course ID and then course name. So now I have two entities, student ID, sorry, student and course, and the primary keys are student IDs and the course IDs. Now let's see. So we have already defined the primary keys, and we said that when we define the primary keys, the primary indexes are automatically created. So right click on the entity and go to key groups. Now key groups is a term used for indexes in your logical data view. Let's check the physical data view. Right click and we have the option of indexes. So in the physical data model, they are called as indexes. In the logical data model, they are called as key groups, which are the same as indexes. It's just a different term. Right click, go to the key groups. So here we can see the entity is student. The key group is XPK student. The type is primary key. This is the name of your index. Now these are the characteristics of this index, the members, what all columns do we have the index on. We have the index on the student ID. We can take it this side. So now we have effectively removed the primary key column. We can see it here. If you remove that column, we have removed the primary key column. So whatever is your primary column, you will have an index on that column. So it comes back to the primary key. Go back to the key groups. Okay. You can select the student first name. If you try to add this column to the primary column, so we just add it over here. We say an okay. What will happen? That will move to the primary key. So primary key index can only exist on the primary key columns. All right. So though it does give us this functionality to be able to add the column name, we have to be sure that we want to add it, then it becomes a primary key. That is the name of the index or the key group that it creates. Then in the general properties, the key group type is primary key. Definition, you can put type on something and put in a definition. You can put your notes. You can have some user defined parameters if you want. So simple. Here, if you click on this new button, you can create an index. Now you only have an option to create an alternate key index, which is a unique index, or an inversion entry index, which is a non-unique index. Right, you do not have an option to create a primary index or a foreign key index. You only have an option to create these two kinds of indexes. So this will be your key group. This will be your index name. If you want to change your names, you can change them here. Right, if you say okay, then it creates a new alternate key index, and we can see it here, AK1, right? So that means alternate key index. Now it has created an index, but we are still going to have to add the columns to this index so that we can add any of these columns. ID is a primary key, so we cannot add that. Student first name we can add and say okay. So now I have an index on this column as well. Now let's go to the course table. Go to the key groups. I already have a primary key index over here on the course ID. That's okay. I say new, and then I select the inversion entry or the non-unique index. So this becomes IE1 course. That is your default naming convention for the key groups. I say okay. I have an option to add the columns. I can add the column over here and I can say okay. So now I have indexes. I have defined indexes on my two entities in the logical data model view. Let's go to the physical data model view and see what it is now. Right click on the indexes. So we can see the two indexes that we have on this table, XPK student, XAK1 student. XPK student is the primary key index. XAK1 student is the alternate key index. then just click on it, click on rename, and you have an option to rename this index to whatever you want. So it might be easy. You might have your own formatting in your database, so you can just follow that or make an easier name for you to understand. Now you can see what are your index members, student ID, your ascending. Now there are some more options, all right, because it's the physical data model view. This is generate, so this will be generated. It will be a generate statement in your SQL when it is generated for this data model, and it will be generated as a constant. You have all these options. What kind of constant state you want? If you want anything initially, would it be created immediate or deferred, validated? All these different options. These are database specific options. So when you we have chosen Oracle when we created this model, that's why it's giving all these options. When you choose some other database, it might be other different database specific options. So for doing this, you have to consult with your DBN and see what kind of indexes are the most efficient. Do you want them deferable or initially or validated? So all these options, what do they mean? You have to consult with your DPA and choose these options accordingly. By default, none of those are selected. What are your physical properties? Is it a parallel index? Are you going to compress this? Are you going to sort this? Are you going to generate statistics on that? So all these things you have to decide in combination with your DPA. Partitions, are you going to have a partition? Which kind of partition, range, hash? Do you want to add a comment on this? So all these different options are available in the physical data model view. So you have to talk with your DBA. You have to understand how you have to efficiently design your indexes, and then you can choose all those actions if needed. Otherwise, this is a default view that you have. Now let's close this. And let's establish a relationship between these two tables. So I want to have, let's say we have a non-identifying relationship. Now, I'm not saying a many-to-many relationship. I'm going to generate a non-identifying relationship. Let us do that in the logical model, okay? So let's generate a non-identifying relationship so that we have the foreign key. We can directly view the foreign key in our table. So I click on this, this becomes my primary table, and this becomes my secondary table. Now what we see when we establish a non-identifying relationship, now we have already discussed, I'm just repeating it, non-identifying relationship is basically when a record in your child entity, which is course in this case, is not dependent entirely on the existence of a record in your parent entity. Then it's a non-identifying relationship, which simply means that a course might exist even if the student does not exist. So the course French will always exist, even if there are four students or there are five students. Let's say I have five students, and one of the students is no longer enrolled in the university, then we are left with four students. So there's a reduction of one student. That doesn't mean that I have the course French would be affected in that case, right? What is an identifying relationship? Identifying relationship is basically a master-child relationship. For example, you have a product and then you have a sub-product. So a sub-product cannot exist until unless you have a product existing in the master table, right? So in that case, that becomes an identifying relationship. And that you can establish by using this button over here. Now, this is a non-identifying relationship. Doesn't matter. We're not concerned about the kind of relationship. What we're concerned about is that now the student ID, which is the primary key of the student entity, has become a foreign key in the course entity. And we just wanted to see this because we want to check the foreign key index for this table. So again, we go to the key groups. Okay, so I cannot see any foreign key index just now. I can just see my primary key and the IE1 index. IE1 is your inversion entry, right? But I cannot see the foreign key index, so I have to go and click over here, show foreign key groups, and now I can see my foreign key index. This is X1, F1 course, IF1. I can rename it. select it, rename it if I want. Now the foreign key index, the key group members automatically are student ID because that is the foreign key for this table. So it automatically selected what this foreign key index should be based upon. Just say okay. Let's go and check the physical data model. Click on this. Right click indexes. And then we have this foreign key index over here, which is this one. If you click on this, you'll be able to see this. This is your index member. This is the position in which you are sending. You can click on this and choose descending if you want. So you can change your student direction, the sorting direction as well. You can choose it to be physical only if you want, right? You have all those different options that we saw earlier, the same options. If I uncheck this, I will not be able to see my foreign key index now. Show FK indexes, right? So this can be checked. I will be able to see my foreign key index. If I uncheck it, I will not be able to see my foreign key index. Okay, let's go back to the logical data model view. So you cannot see them on the left hand side on the model screen. You cannot see your indexes. You have to right click, go to the key groups in case of the logical data model, or go to indexes in case of the physical data model, and you can see them.